Hi all, today we are going to discuss about receiving and power circle diagram. So sometimes it is easier to draw the circle diagrams and find the parameters from there instead of going for the normal procedure. Let us take, for example, I am taking a transmission line. There is a transmission line, so which is connected to some load. So this is my load. So I am taking my reference and as my reference. So this is my sending and voltage. Let us assume it is making an angle of delta, and ABCD parameters are there for the transmission line. So I already know my value of this receiving end power, and I want to calculate what is the value of the sending end voltage, or I want to know what is the maximum power that can be transmitted to this, or what is the requirement, or what is the capacity of compensating equipment required. In those cases, this will be very much useful. That means this can be used when, if you know the value of, let us assume, PR, theta R, that means receiving and power angle, or receiving and power factor angle, and receiving and voltage, and ABCD parameters. Then we can easily calculate what is the value of the sending end voltage, or we can also calculate what is the capacity of compensating equipment, as well as we can also calculate what is the maximum receiving end power. So this can be easily calculated using the receiving and power circle diagram. We have to remember here, receiving and power circle diagram name came because we know the values of the receiving end parameters, and we want to calculate the sending end parameters or the compensating or other parameters. So let us see how to get this. So we can calculate my receiving end power, apparent power is equal to VR multiplied by IR conjugate, because this we already know. So from the ABCD parameters, because we know the value of VS is equal to, so let me write here, Vs is equal to A times of Vr plus B times of Ir. So from this I can calculate my value of Ir is equal to, just divide everywhere by B. So this will become Vs by B minus A by B times of Vr. So this value you get. So that I am substituting here. So this will become equal to Vr multiplied by Vs by B minus A times of Vr divided by B. This I have to take the conjugate. So let us assume that with respect to our making the angles, let us assume A is making an angle of A at an angle of alpha, and B is making an angle of B at an angle of beta, and we know D is equal to A. So from that we can calculate all the remaining parameters. Let us try to substitute here and calculate them. So from this we can calculate this value as Vs multiplied by Vr multiplied by B at an angle of beta minus delta. So you can just multiply it, because you have to take the conjugate for these angles, remember this. So then the second one becomes A times of Vr square divided by B, let us take the magnitudes, at an angle of beta minus alpha. This is what we get. So let us take it as equation number 1. So now if power factor at the receiving end is, let us assume, is equal to theta r, then we can write from equation number 1. So this Vr multiplied by Ir multiplied by cos theta r, this represents my active power at the receiving end. So this can be obtained from equation number 1 also by taking cosine of the angle. So I am just writing this as Vs Vr by B into cos of beta minus delta minus A times of Vr square by B into cos of beta minus alpha. So this value is B. So let us take it as equation number 2. Similar way, I can calculate my reactive power as Vr Ir sin theta r. This will be equal to receiving and reactive power is equal to Vs Vr by B into sin beta minus delta minus A times of Vr square by B sin beta minus alpha. Let us take it as equation number 3. So now what I am doing, taking my equation number 2 square plus equation number 3 square and adding them. If you add them, that sum of P square plus Q square. So that I can write as PR plus A times of VR, because whatever is in the negative in the second side, that I am bringing to this side, A times of VR square by B cos of beta minus alpha whole square plus QR plus A times of VR square divided by B into sine of beta minus alpha whole square. This will be this one square plus this one square. This will become cos square beta minus delta plus sin square beta minus delta will become equal to 1. So this will become equal to Vs multiplied by Vr divided by b. This entire thing will be square. You can see that this will be the radius of my circle and the center will be at these two locations. We already know the equation of a circle, how to do it. So let us take if PR and QR are on x axis and y axis respectively. So this equation number 4 shows equation of circle. So this equation of circle, it shows that it is having a radius of Vs Vr divided by b. This is the radius of the circle and centered at, so what is the value? So first one, because PR, this entire equation we have to equate to 0, so this will become minus a times of Vr square divided by b. This is a magnitude, this will be cos of beta minus alpha, and second one is a times of Vr square by b. This also will be minus sine of beta minus alpha. So this is what we get, this is the center. So here you can see the variable out of all these things, because once the transmission line is fixed, the alpha, beta, all the parameters are fixed. Only variables that can be varied is the value of the delta. Delta is the angle between the receiving end and the sending end voltage. So by varying that, we can get the equation for a circle. Let us see how to draw the circle diagram. So to draw the circle diagram, first thing is, let us assume I know my value of PR, theta r, vr and abcd constants are known. Let us assume I already know these parameters. So first, what we have to do, first thing is convert to single phase quantities, or you can do with the even three phase quantities, then all the values should be in three phase, or because in order to avoid the confusion, generally three phase quantities are converted to paraphase quantities. So voltage, current, voltage and power and all these things. So once these are done, the second one is, first we should know the values of the center. The center is given by a times of Vr square by b. So calculate a multiplied by Vr square divided by b. So once this is calculated and we already know the value of Pr, so choose a proper scale. We have to choose a scale so that can be easily mapped, or easily the parameters can be known. So once these are done, I am trying to draw the diagram. Anyway, the steps and the required theory I have kept in the material. I have given the link in the description below. You can download the material from there. Now try to understand what is the procedure I am explaining. So first thing is, I am just taking my x-axis. X-axis is the active power and y-axis is my reactive power, MVAR. So now we have to select some point O. Let us assume I have selected my point O. So once after selecting my point O, then what is the next step you have to do? You have to take the radius will be A by B times of Vr square. A by B times of Vr square, we have seen the center of the circle is minus A by B times of Vr square, and second one is minus A by B times of Vr square. One is cos beta minus alpha, one is sin beta minus alpha. So let us assume in the x-axis, this will be A by B times of Vr square cos of, that angle is beta minus alpha. You have to take this distance in the x-axis. Similarly, you have to take the distance in the y-axis, that will be equal to A by B times of Vr square sin beta minus alpha. Let us assume that corresponding location is coming at some point here. So now join the point O to this point. So let us take this point as CR, or we can tell the length of this one, this will be equal to A by B times of Vr square. As it is coming in the negative direction, so we can tell this angle will be equal to beta minus alpha in the third quadrant. That means we have to take the angle beta minus alpha in the third quadrant, and with respect to this third quadrant, with respect to the x-axis, negative x-axis, take the angle beta minus alpha, and with the length equal to A by B times of Vr square, draw a line, that line will come as CR. So once this is done, the next step will be, we know our value of the power. So as you know the value of the power, so from this point you just draw with the power factor angle, because we know the angle is power factor angle is phi r. So this length should be equal to your upper end power at my receiving end. So this should be equal to SR. This SR is equal to PR plus J times of QR. Let us assume it is intersecting at some point P. So if you know, let us assume only the active power. So active power will be projection on the x-axis. Corresponding to the value of the active power, draw a perpendicular line. And wherever this theta R line is intersecting, that gives your apparent value of the power. So that is a point P. So now, join this CR with the P. So I am just joining this CR with the point P. So this will be equal to, this indicates my radius. So this will be Vs Vr by B. Because we have got from the equation, this will be Vs Vr by B. So once the radius is measured, so from that, if we already know the value of Vr, we know the value of B, we can easily calculate the value of Vs if Vs is unknown. Let us assume if Vs is known, you got the circle. So now this indicates the radius. So now draw a circle with this radius. So I have drawn a circle. So let us see how to find the different quantities from this. So before proceeding for the different quantities, let us try to find the angles. What are the angles that will be subtended? So that I am drawing here, let us assume I am drawing a horizontal line. So this angle is equal to beta minus alpha. So automatically this angle also will be equal to beta minus alpha. This will be equal to beta minus alpha. And the angle that is subtended by this this radius. So what is the angle that is subtended? We can see from the original equation, what is the radius? The radius is varying. Here you can see here, this will be beta minus delta will come here. So beta minus delta. So this angle is the angle subtended with respect to this one. So this angle will be equal to beta minus delta. So you got the value of beta minus delta. This angle is beta minus alpha. So to take this delta as a reference, we have to add delta to this. That means at this point beta will be there. So let us try to extend a line. So let us assume that this angle gap, this is equal to delta. So that this is my reference line for calculating the delta. So what will be the gap between this reference line and this angle? So what will be this angle? So this angle will be, because this is beta minus alpha, if you add alpha to this, so here it will be alpha. If you add alpha to this, you are getting the angle beta. And this will be beta minus delta. If you add angle delta, you are getting this. Or otherwise, we can tell the angle that is subtended here, or the angle between the reference points on this plane will be, this will be equal to beta. So at the angle of beta, you have to take the reference point. From the reference point, if you take the delta, that indicates what is the value of the moment or a particular line at a particular point. So once these are obtained, let us see the various component how to calculate. So let us assume this is my operating point. From this operating point, you just project downwards. So this indicates what is the value of the active power at particular instant. And this value indicates what is the value of the reactive power at the corresponding point. Now, this circle is coming. So this angle, let us assume this is CR and it is intersecting at a point M. Let us assume this vertical line, when you draw, let us assume this is intersecting at some point F. So this FM indicates the maximum receiving end power. This indicates the maximum value of receiving end power. So let me try to repeat the circle diagram once again. So what are the procedures? Steps I am repeating once again so that it will be completely clear to you. So first you have to take the x-axis and the y-axis. So x-axis is in megawatts, y-axis is in MVAR. So take some point O. So from this point O, with an angle of beta minus alpha, draw one line. The length of the line, this length of the line will be equal to A by B times of VR square. This much length of the line you take, let us take it as CR. So now from this point, you know your active power. Let us assume this is my value of the receiving end active power. So from this active power, you just extend the line. So now from O, you just draw a line with an angle equal to receiving end power angle. So this angle is equal to theta r. So this will intersect at some point. So wherever this is intersecting, this point is called as point number P. So now with center as CR and point P as a radius, draw a circle. So a circle will be drawn like this, which is going through P. A circle will be drawn, and what is the radius of this circle? Radius of circle will be here this will be my radius of the circle. Sorry, because I was not able to draw properly. So this is my radius of a circle. This radius will be Vs Vr divided by b. This is my radius of a circle. Up to here it is clear. So now correspondingly, whatever value is coming, this indicates my reactive power. So now this angle is beta minus alpha. So with respect to this, if you calculate this, so this angle up to here will be equal to beta minus alpha due to symmetry of the triangle. And this angle that is subtended, how much angle this will make, that means this radius will go on changing or the value will change. So this value, if we calculate, this will be equal to beta minus delta. You can see from the voltage equations. So now, as this is beta minus delta, the reference point for delta, or we can calculate beta by adding alpha to this value. So I am just adding the extra value. This value is alpha. So when you add alpha, so this becomes your reference line for calculating the value of delta. So if this is beta minus delta, so automatically this will be equal to delta. This way you can calculate my delta. So now if you want to calculate the maximum power, just extend this line as well as extend this origin. So this indicates what is your maximum receiving end power. So if you want to calculate the sending end voltage, just measure the radius. We know the value of Vr, we know the value of B. So from that we can calculate my value of the sending end voltage. So in this way you have to calculate. So how to calculate the compensating equipment, what is the effect of the compensating equipment and those things, to explain that we will take one numerical in the next class and explain that so that it will be completely clear to you. I hope it is clear up to now. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.